Okay, so for this tutorial, you will need leather conditioner. This is just the Oakwood leather conditioner. You will need a cloth for the actual leather conditioner. Then you will need a cloth for the water, and you'll need tack. I don't actually have the tack with me today, so I'm just going to be using boots, and I've got chaps as well. But I would pretty much clean them the exact same way. Okay, so you're going to need water. I just started by hosing off the majority of the gunk because I like to think of cleaning tack like moisturizing yourself. You wouldn't put moisturizer on a filthy body, you'd wash yourself off first. So, I've got the boots here and I've got like a little bowl of water that I'm obviously going to wash. I'm not going to drink from it or put anything in it. But I'm just dipping the cloth in the water and saturating my boots and removing all of the gunk, because putting leather conditioner on with the gunk on is just going to trap all of the dirt. So I'm just rubbing really thoroughly all over the boots, trying to dig my fingers into the creases and getting rid of any dirt that we can see, and trying to bring up dirt that you can't necessarily see. So I'm doing that on both boots. Okay, so now we're going to condition the boots. I'm taking the leather conditioner. This is, like I said, the Oakwood leather conditioner. It's really cheap and works really well. I'm just going to put it onto this cloth. Now make sure you use different cloths for water and conditioner because it can get incredibly soapy. And I'm just going to massage it into the whole boot and just rubbing it in and massaging it in like you would if you were putting moisturizer on yourself. And I'm basically doing it in sections, so I pretty much divide the tack or my riding boot into sections and then apply a certain amount onto the cloth and just do it. You'll kind of figure out how much you need the more you go along. I'm just popping a little bit more on now and putting it onto the side sections and the back sections. You can never have too much leather conditioner is my theory, so top up on it if you feel like you need it. It will of course dry up by the time you ride next. It usually dries overnight. But it just keeps your tack looking really shiny and really clean. And I honestly just love how it makes your tack look, this conditioner. So I'm just massaging it in, making sure I go into the creases as well, because obviously you want to keep that oily as well. And I'm pretty much going to do the exact same thing on the other boot. So just applying it on the cloth, massaging it in. The more you massage it in, the more the white disappears. You will see the white appear under the creases though, like the conditioner. But eventually it'll go away. But yeah, I'm just massaging it all in and making sure I cover the entire boot. Also the part, don't do underneath the boot because that's not leather, so you don't want to put leather conditioner on something that's not leather. And open up the zipper and do inside there as well. And try and avoid that, like, it's almost like a semicircle. So I'm doing underneath the zipper as well just to make sure it really conditions and stays nice and soft. It makes your boots look incredibly shiny and they will suffer less wear and tear. Now on to chaps. Chaps can be a little bit harder, but again, I'm just washing off all the gunk, getting it out of the creases, and chaps are a bit more in contact with the dirt, so you really want to make sure you get rid of all the gunk. I did hose off like the strap on the bottom so that I don't have to clean that off. But you can hose the inside of the boot, the chap. I find that that's fine. It might loosen the grip a little, but that's okay. And you can give it a very light hose, but then I just like to go over it with the wet cloth I was using previously and just go really into the crease, get rid of all of the gunk. And now I'm just getting the leather conditioner, popping some onto the conditioner cloth. And these are just cut up face washes, by the way. So you don't really need anything special. And I'm just going to massage it onto the chaps. Chaps are a little bit easier to do because they're obviously flat. It was really hard for me to do it holding them because I usually do it on a table. But basically you just put the leather conditioner all over the entire leather part of the chap. And yeah, I don't, like I said, I like to not take it easy on the conditioner and put heaps on there, but it just keeps them looking prettier. So basically I just keep putting the leather conditioner on and on and on until I feel it has thoroughly covered the entire chap. And then I'm just doing the same thing on the other chap. So putting the water on, getting rid of the gunk, and then putting the conditioner on. This routine keeps your boots and tack looking incredibly shiny. They look like brand new. Stops them from suffering wear and tear. They keep stay shinier for longer and they're really soft. Do this after every single ride and they will stay like that. I do this for all of the tack, not just my boots. Click here to watch last week's video on the top link, which was a beauty tag, and click on the one below to watch my latest riding video where I did a self-jump lesson commentary. And here are my social accounts if you want to go find me on the World Wide Web. But until then, see you next time.